The play Footloose on stage at Chanhassen Dinner Theaters has one remarkable moment after another, and it can be argued that perhaps one of the sweetest is when these two characters sing Almost Paradise. These two characters, Alan Bach and Maya Richardson, who play Wren and Ariel in our show. The two of you are not only wonderful actors and singers and dancers individually, but my goodness, the chemistry you create for us in this show is beautiful. Chemistry becomes very important in the art of being an actor, an actress, a dancer, a singer, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can't create it. So, where did you guys find your chemistry? In rehearsals, I assume.
We got really lucky, because the first time we ever met was the first time we sang Almost Paradise together.
That's true, yeah.
We had no idea.
At our music director's house. Like, we just showed up and that was our first meeting.
It could have been horrible. And it wasn't.
We'd never sung together. We didn't have an audition together, and we sang through the song once, and I think we just all kind of paused for a moment and looked at each other and
Andy
said,
was like, okay, oh yeah. He was like, this is perfect.
In Footloose, each of you comes from a place of real sorrow. Wren, your father has left and you and your mother need to move to this small town. Maya, your brother, killed in an accident that revolved around dancing. So both of you are filled with sorrow, but through the course of this, both of you find such joy. Where do those moments within the play come for you?
When they meet the first time, they recognize that sort of sorrow and those pieces of themselves in each other. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of special. Like, you know, when you meet someone, you're like, oh wait, like, I feel like I know you and I know about that.
Yeah.
I think they have that special sort of connection.
Wren finds dance and it's this important outlet. And you, Maya, as your character Ariel, are just rooted in rebellion. You feel like you're wearing a straitjacket and you want out. You'll do anything dumb to get out.
Yeah. I think she's truly just trying to find a way to survive in a town that's really fear-based. They're not letting themselves feel, they're not letting themselves dance and like release. So she's truly searching for any kind of way to just feel something.
And within that rebellion, it brings each of you into conflict with parents. But the conflicts are very real. And underneath all of it, your characters have to find that we love each other. And sometimes your parents really try that ability for you to get over the bridge, don't they?
I think there's a version of, especially her father, that she misses, because he's not letting himself grieve and he shuts down and she doesn't recognize him. And she misses him and she's just trying to really get him back.
You had already said early on, Maya, that you saw in your characters something common, this sorrow. And it's kind of the sorrow that brings you together. But this is not a sorrowful play. I mean, it's really about the joy of resolving so many of these issues, isn't it?
Yeah. I think they find each other, and I think he's intriguing to her because he's from a big city, and I think she's intriguing to him because she longs for a bigger and better world than what she's living in. And I think together they push that status quo. I think that's the beauty of them being the young leaders of the town. I think young people sometimes have a better understanding. They haven't been burned yet, I don't think. They're curious enough to say that when something doesn't look or feel or seem right, let's change it. And they don't have maybe some of the wisdom that the older people have to know why maybe it's a certain way.
That drive to change, to persevere, to make it better is very youthful. And it kind of points out to us that young people, youth, really do make big changes for the rest of us. Your whole town changed because Wren came, you got together, and you kept pushing. You made great change.
Yeah, I think he allows a sort of spark within the town that maybe they're scared of. And we're not scared yet because we're still so young. And I think it also takes people who maybe are not necessarily younger, but if they have that youth, they still have the curiosity and the spark to be like, oh, okay, maybe I'll take this step and keep going and keep trying.
there are moments on stage for actors that are, oops, oh my gosh. Do you have some moments on stage about Alan that you're going to tell us right now?
That should be good.
Oh my goodness. We are just so silly. It's just, it's too bad. But sometimes Alan will laugh a little bit and he'll kind of have a really small smile on his face and the mic will pick up this little sound and he'll be like, and he's like trying not to laugh.
Okay, I need a moment about your co-star.
In Almost Paradise, at the very end, where we come, you're like really big, broad singing as big as you go, and then we turn into each other and it's very soft and quiet. And for whatever reason, maybe I have a hard time walking slowly. So like every once in a while I have like a little like bobble, and then we're supposed to be
He looks like a little toddler walking and is like, oopsie.
And her face when that happens is like, it's all my fault, really. So.
And we're always making eye contact. So if something goes wrong, we're like, mm-mm.
You really do read each other, don't you?
Yeah. It's a lot of trust.
It's a real, real fine ballet all the way through it.
But Maya's been amazing to work with. Every step of the way. Not only do we have fun, but like I can trust her 100%.
Ditto.
And it's easy to make it look fun because it is
sincere. It is so fun.
You're laying all this out, all of your talent, all of your ability, and you're pretty raw when you're doing that. And if you have a partner that you can trust who has your back, it's really everything, isn't it?
It's really lucky. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really cool. I'm very just grateful that this is our job and it's cool to do it with someone you trust as a friend. It's really special.
In two sentences or less, why should people love Footloose and come and see you?
People are gonna love Footloose because they're going to not only hear songs that they love and know, I think they're going to feel in their heart a change and a revelation by the end of the play.
I think people should come because they'll feel human and just share with the humanity of the sorrow, but working through it and finding the joy.
Finding the joy is very much what this play is about. And I promise you that a big reason you will find the joy is because of these two remarkable young people. Maya Richardson, of course, is Ariel. Alan Bach as Ren. We are lucky to have you. Don't fall down and hurt yourself.
We'll do our best.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nancy.